Upinder, working as an associate professor in the department of ECE. Today I'd like to give a demonstration, a pre-video lecture on antennas and wave propagation. So here in this subject, as per JNT, we have 5 units. So in the first unit, we'll be discussing the antenna basics. The first unit we'll be discussing completely the antenna basics. So here, the summary of this unit and what all we will be discussing here is what is an antenna, the definition of an antenna, and if I want to use any antenna for practical applications, or if I want to use it for practical applications in any transmitting and receiving purpose, so what are all the parameters that an antenna should satisfy, like various parameters of an antenna which can decide the quality of an antenna, like directivity, the effective length, effective aperture area, so on. There are many antenna parameters which are need to be measured so that I want to use any antenna for practical applications. So all the antenna parameters and basics are discussed in the first unit. So once after I know the basics of any given antenna, now I'll be very fine with an antenna. Later on, now how to construct an antenna? How to construct a basic antenna to the microwave frequency antenna. So this subject, the beauty of the subject is, first we will learn how to, what is an antenna, then how to construct an antenna. So here I will take a simple wire antenna, a small wire. By using this wire antenna, I take a linear antenna, and if I mount that wire antenna into some shape of helix, which is called as a helical antenna. So here in the second unit, we will be discussing about wire antennas, helical antennas, Yagi-Uda antennas, which is a basic antenna of my TV communication, and also we will be knowing a part of basics of the microstrip antenna. So this is what we have in the second unit. Coming to third unit, I will be doing a bit extension of the antennas. Now basic antennas have been discussed, so now we are going to the bigger antennas. I have my horn antennas. So horn antennas play an important role in day-to-day life, where we use our mobile communication. So every mobile operator, whoever it may be, India, Airtel, whoever it may be, everybody uses my horn antenna. So horn antenna, also apart from this, we also use the microstrip antennas for effective communication, where the efficiency is high between transmitter and receiver. So the first 3 units completely discuss or tell you about the antenna and types of antennas, either at the lower level or the micro frequency level. Coming to the 4th unit, I have my wave propagations. So what do I discuss here? So in the first 3 units, I knew what is an antenna, then types of antennas, right from the basic level antenna, wire antenna, to the horn antenna. Now in this 4th unit, how can we use these antennas and how the wave is propagated from transmitter towards the receiver? For example, if I am using a horn antenna, where my antenna tower is there, for example my horn antenna is in this shape. If I am using it for wave propagation, somewhere here my receiver is, and how the wave is being propagated, by either it is using ground wave propagation, or it is going for ionosphere layer and coming for propagation. So different types of propagations are discussed in the 4th unit, like ground wave propagation, like sky wave propagation, ionosphere wave propagation. So many different types of propagations are discussed in the wave propagations. And coming to the last unit of this subject, we will be discussing what are all the parameters related to this wave propagation section. That means, for example, if I am Hyderabad, I want to communicate with a person who is in US. If this need to be happened, with how much frequency should I apply a signal, should I send a signal so that it goes till ionosphere layer and comes back towards the receiver. So that frequency is usually measured as critical frequency. So below that, if I apply the signal, the frequency of the signal is below that, it will not go to the ionosphere and communication will not be possible. So the maximum usable frequency, critical frequency, skip distance, and such parameters are discussed in this 5th unit. So this is the overview of the subject, where we will be learning complete information about the antennas. What is an antenna? Different types of antennas, right from the basic antenna, wire antenna, till the micro frequency antennas like horn antennas, microstrip antennas, helical antennas, so on. And fourth and fifth unit tells us how the wave is propagated from one antenna transmitter to the receiver and also from receiver to the transmitter if I am giving a reply. So on all this, let us discuss about an antenna in detail. And for now, I will be taking my Hazel antenna, which is mostly widely used antenna. Helical antenna. So helical antenna is simply, before going into this, what are the topics I want to discuss here? First of all, let us discuss basics and properties of a helical antenna. First topic is basics and properties of helical antenna. Next, let us see how it is constructed or what is the structure of a helical antenna. And the next one is how it is operated. We have modes of operation. And next we have applications. So before that, we can also take the radiation properties or what are the various properties of a helical antenna. So these five topics are more than enough to know about a helical antenna. Basics properties, structure, modes of operation, radiation properties and applications. So first one, if I want to know the basics and properties, how do I construct the antenna? First, the first one is, I take a simple wire and mould the wire, mould in the sense, change the shape of the wire into the structure of a helix. This shape is called helix. If any wire is taken, one end of the wire is here and the other end of the wire is here. If I mould the shape of the wire into some helix shape, and this number may be any number, that number n is dependent upon my radiation capacity. How much distance I want radiation, and that is dependent on that particular length of the given wire. If I am taking 1 meter of wire, if each of 10 centimeters circumference, which gives me 10, which is equal to 10 circles. So that depends, my length and radiation depends on my number of turns and the length of the helix and length of the wire antenna that I am taking. So this is how I just take the basics of a helical antenna. Helical antenna is simply an antenna which is constructed by using a wire and which shape is molded into the shape of the helix. And one end of the wire is applied with the input, where the total antenna radiates by electromagnetic waves. So this is about the antenna. And coming to properties. The beauty of this helical antenna is the helical antenna always gives you circular polarization. It gives you circular polarization. Now what do you mean by circular polarization? Let us see what means polarization initially. See, for example, this is my globe or earth, if I am taking. I have my electric field vector here. For example, this is my electric field vector. If I want to know, knowing the direction of the electric field vector, knowing the direction of the electric field vector with respect to the surface of the earth is called polarization. So the polarization can be either linear polarization, it can be circular polarization, it can be elliptical polarization, right? Again, linear can be more, it can be a horizontal polarization, it can be a vertical polarization, any one of these. So that's again a part of the new story. But here, knowing the electric field vector direction with respect to the earth surface is called polarization, and that can be any of this. So here, why am I taking helical antenna widely is, the beauty of this is, any helical antenna gives you 360 degrees communication, 360 degrees effective communication. You don't have minor lobes. The effect of the minor lobes is very smaller. Minor lobes are nothing but they are called error lobes. Always we are only bothered about the maximum radiation, right? So maximum radiation is nothing but my major lobe. Any radiation pattern should only have major lobes and less amount of minor lobes. So that radiation pattern is seen in a helical antenna, because a helical antenna gives you circular polarization. This is the reason why a helical antenna is always preferred. Helical antenna always gives you circular polarization. You can find the electromagnetic wave throughout the 360 degrees. Wherever you find it also, the amount of major lobe is more when compared to the minor lobes. So minor lobes are nothing but error lobes, and they are of back lobes. You have side lobes, right? So these are always error lobes. They should not be present on the radiation pattern. We only should have the major lobe. So this comes under the first part, basics and properties. Now let me take the construction. So now how do I construct a helical antenna? So helical antennae is constructed by taking a simple wire. So this is how I construct. So this is my helical antenna. This is my ground plane. Ground plane is only used for some mechanical safety, so that the helix structure will not get spoiled due to the temperature, any environmental disturbances. So each one is for a helix. Actually, this complete is a simple wire, but the wire only is molded into the shape of the helix. Each space or the spacing between any two successive helix, each shape is called helix. That is why the name helical antenna is come. Right? The spacing between these two is called S. One height, or you can simply say one circumference, one complete circle, maybe the diameter D. Since this becomes a circle, if I see from this view, if my view is like this, I treat it as diameter D. So therefore, and if I'm taking the cross section which is in this way, I am taking it in this way. Now what happens? This becomes my circumference, which is completely taken into this, and this becomes my spacing S. So taking this mathematically here, I can draw it like this. This is my circumference. This becomes my spacing S. So by Pythagoras theorem, I am taking an angle alpha. So Pythagoras theorem, I can write this one as S square plus C square under root, where C is my circumference. So here we also know circumference is equal to 2 pi r. I can write this as 2 r into pi. So but 2 r is diameter, so I can write d into pi. So therefore my circumference is always equal to pi into d. So using this property here, I can write my, for example, this is length l naught. I can write l naught is equal to, l naught is equal to, I can write pi into d, which is my circumference. Right? So here this becomes under root of s square plus pi square d square. Now why am I calculating my alpha? Is the alpha plays an important role here. The alpha plays an important role. If I am taking tan alpha there in the helical antenna construction, what can I write? I can write it as s by circumference, s by c, where alpha is equal to tan inverse of s by c. Taking this into consideration, any electronic engineer when constructing a helical antenna should mandatorily satisfy this condition, alpha is equal to tan inverse s by c, where s is the spacing between two successive helix and c is my circumference, where c is also equal to pi into ld, pi d. So therefore, what if my alpha is 0? What if my alpha is 0? First case, there are three cases here. If alpha is 0, what happens? If this case is 0, now that means no gap is here, completely there is no spacing between this. If alpha is equal to 0, then automatically the spacing S is equal to 0. If S spacing is equal to 0, that means each and every helix is over one another. All the helix are at one place only. Then that tells you all the helix are one upon another, upon each other. Now when they are on one upon each other, we call that antenna as loop antenna. Okay. A helical antenna can also be used as a loop antenna when the alpha is 0 degrees. There is no spacing between one helix to the other helix. If I make it 0, automatically each and every helix will be one upon each other, which makes you a loop antenna. So this is very important. How can you convert a helical antenna to a loop antenna? Simply by making the alpha is equal to 0. And taking the second case, case 2, if I am making alpha is equal to 90 degrees, if I am making this alpha is equal to 90 degrees means this will be somewhere here. Now in this is in this direction, this is in the direction, means the S is never formed. S is always open. That means the spacing is infinite. The spacing becomes infinite. If the spacing becomes infinite, now what do I call that? I call it as linear antenna. call it linear tangent because I am not able to form a helix there. The S is in this direction, the circumference, and the alpha will be in this moving this direction, so they will not meet each other at any point, which converts into a linear angle. And if alpha is equal to 0 to 90 degrees, then we call it helical angle. Right? Thank you, sir.